God ridiculed the workers before the work had started. Chapter 2, verse 19. You don't have to turn there. It said they mocked and ridiculed him. Here in chapter 4, he gave a speech of the army of Samaria, and the ridicule increased. Notice he called the workers feeble. It would tick me off if somebody would just say to me that this little church is not going to make it. This little church is dying on its vine. That would get me stirred up, you know. Because they'd be wrong. That word means withered and miserable. And we get withered sometimes, amen, and get tired. But we all got a vision. We know what God's going to do. Next, he ridiculed the job that they were doing, asking four questions. Will they fortify themselves, or will they restore their wall? Will they build a wall? That must have made the Samaritan army break out in laughter. How could a remnant of feeble Jews build a wall? Build a wall, how can they do it? And they're strong enough to protect the city from a mighty army. Will they sacrifice? Sandra is saying that. It will take more than a prayer and worship to build that city. Will they make an end in a day, or will they finish in a day? Suggesting that the workers had no idea how difficult the task was going to be. They will soon stop what they were doing. You know,
you knew that Miss Mary had worked in the factories, Mary had worked there, and people come by and said, "You might as well just give that up. He ain't done no good." Discouraged, doesn't he? And your neighbor,
they walk in. I think it ought to be an Arkansas law that everybody meets the general public 1 year of their life to see what's going on. But Satan tries to discourage us, doesn't he? And then he said, will they revive the stones, or can they bring these stones back to life? And that was doing, you know, just rubbish. Which indicated to them that their building material was so old and damaged that they couldn't use it to make a strong building. God had other plans, amen. They tried to get them to give up. When people tell us, you need to give up, that just gives me an extra strength to go on. Mm-hmm. Look at the first part of verse 10 in chapter 4. And Judah said, the strength of the bearers of burdens is decayed. They had David's blood in their veins. And you would think that they had more faith and courage than the rest of the people. They were looked as leaders and pace setters, and the tribe of Judah was bummed out. Then the other tribes would be more inclined to give up as well. The first cause of internal discouragement was fatigue. They were tired. They were just giving out. They'd been hitting it hard and needed some rest. When you're physically drained, it's very easy to become discouraged. Brother Gordon keeps going in all directions. Look at verse 6. They were really excited about when they start a new project. First half goes up easy, doesn't it? But then, we're excited about accomplishing the goal. But when the newness wears off and the work becomes routine and boring, then it becomes tired. When you're tired, it's easy to become more discouraged and begin to think that you'll never finish the job. They said there was so much rubble, but they could not rebuild the city. They were ready to just throw in the towel. Why keep doing it? That's what was happening to this church over the years. Too many people threw in the towel. Amen. We can't handle it. We don't have enough people. We can't do it by ourselves. These are the same people who described in verse 6 as the ones that work with all their heart. If you're feeling fatigued today, it can lead to discouragement. Remember what God, when Elijah was tired, he sent an angel to give him some bread and something to drink and told him to go back to sleep. God knew it. Elijah needed rest. We all need rest. Amen? Well, some people it takes more. You cannot burn the candle with both hands. I'll tell you something. I'll tell you folks. People will step by in church and let you do all the work. Amen? You shouldn't have to do everybody's work. Everybody's supposed to carry the load. But you can't burn a candle at both ends either and be strong in the Lord. You just can't do it. You've got to get some rest. Sometimes the spiritual thing is do it. Go to bed. Don't quit. But get you some rest and come back refreshed. The second thing that can happen is that you get to listen to Pope again. Look at verse 3. It was Tobias turned and ridiculed the workers when he tried to joke on them. He said, if they build it, will a fox climb it and tear the wall down? And here they was trying to build a wall and ask somebody if you build it, a fox would tear it down. That'd make me mad, too. Esther say that the walls were 9 feet and would need a lot more than a fox to tear it down. The worker became the punchline of every joke. Everyone got a laugh at their expense. Tobias hoped that his sarcasm would make the builders get discouraged and quit, which is what the world thinks of us. When we say Westside Baptist is coming back stronger than ever was, even 30 years ago, I still believe that with all my heart. God can do it with these very people right here. If we just put our heart and mind to it. Yeah. The second cause of it was repression, verses 7 and 8. When it came to pass that when Sanballat and Tobiah and the Arabians and the Ammonites and the Ashdodites heard that the walls of Jerusalem were made up and the breaches began to stop, and there were wars aroused. Verse 8. And conspired all of them together to come and to fight against Jerusalem and to hinder it. So, have you ever attempted to get involved in the work of the Lord? You faced ridicule right off the start. Amen. As long as we set back, we're no hindrance to Satan. If we start doing the Lord's work, Satan will be there. People say, well, Satan don't bother me. I said, you don't have to do nothing. But if you do something, he will bother you.
Amen.
The second cause of discouragement was oppression, like I said. And they all plotted to come out and fight Jerusalem and stir trouble up. Do you know the devil will send his little cronies to all churches to start problems? They may not call us to quit, but they call them just to give up. The writer, God's people sometimes have difficulty working together. But the people of the world have no problem uniting opposition to the work of the Lord. Never will forget last big work that we had. I think it was 15, 20 people should show up. But John had been along. Preacher, who you meant to get? I said, the teenage boys. They thought, oh Lord, that man is going to kill us. But you know, he worked right beside them, so they couldn't say nothing at all. They told me they didn't want you as their boss anymore, brother. You were too tough on them. So they stayed clear. These workers were surrounded in all corners, and it constantly be in fear all the time. The pressure from without often creates problems within. Oppositions outside the ranks can lead to depression on the inside. You military people, get discouraged because you were naked. It wasn't the voice of the enemy that was the most persuasive to the workers. It was the voice of God's own people, just like today. It was God's own people saying, you can't do that. There's no way you can do it. You know, I honestly think that when a person that's saved gets to working for the Lord and you see the fruit coming out, that people get jealous of them. You know, I do. I believe that. You get your preachers out there that want to out, you know, out-preach the other. You get singers out there that want to out-sing the others. God's not interested in that. They said there's so much rubble, they can't build a wall. Became discouraged and getting so aggravated in the situations. And I'm sure they were having to deal with broken rocks. It was in the rubble, dirt, dried out water, every other degree. But all around them, junk was everywhere. Just as they lost sight of their goal, when we have too much garbage in our lives, it causes problems, as they did. Hebrews 12:1 challenges us to get rid of anything that causes us to be frustrated in our walk with the Lord. I don't know what the rubble was in your life, and none of my business. But God knows what it is. And if it's holding you back from serving Him, you need to throw it out and get rid of it. Amen.
Amen.
Another cause of discouragement is fear. Fear. Enemies of the Lord's work that's struck hard with the people building a wall, and they felt like giving up. We can't rebuild the wall. Did you notice in verse 12 who gets prayed the quickest? Look at verse 12. And it came to pass that when the Jews were dealt by them came, they said unto us 10 times, of all places which you shall turn out, they will be. Hang on a minute. Read that. Do somebody read verse 12 if you would, please. I'm sorry. Thank you, ma'am. Who was the quickest? Those affected by fear or those who hang around pessimistic people? If you want to limit depressing thoughts, stay away from those people. Amen. Stay away from them for bringing you down. It's not good to hang around folks that's steadily complaining and steadily whining.
Amen.
I don't like to be around them. I'm not going to be around them. It's like the old saying, if you're going to soar with the eagles, you can't run around with the turkeys, amen?
No.
You like that, didn't you?
I haven't heard that one.
That comes from Hall of Road right there. You know? Fear puts a frame of us, a frame of mind. We can only become discouraged, but we can also become deceived. 60% of our fears are totally unfounded. They never happen. 20% of the fears are behind us, and 10%, they don't even make a difference. Would you like to know? 5% are real, you can't find anything about them, and 5%, we don't know what happened. But the cure is for discouragement. We see some of the causes, the ridicule, the response leading to get it depressed. You don't have to live with it anymore being depressed. Look at the three cures for it. Request God's help. But God, this thing is too big. I can't handle it. In the jungles of Africa, a man was chasing a roaring, hungry lion, feeling the lion's hot breath at his neck, knowing that his time was short. He broke out in a prayer and ran like crazy. Oh Lord, please make this lion a Christian. And when he looked behind, he found a lion kneeling and moving his lips on Aubrey's prayer. So he was in trouble. Greatly relieved at his offense, he got close enough to the Lord to hear them pray and bless, oh Lord, for this food I'm about to receive. Let me buy that. Nehemiah questions God.